Hello students, today we are going to talk about the activity 5 which is related to your last video of big 5 personality traits. So this is the link provided in your textbook, so you need to put this link on the Google, that is nobaproject.com/modules/personality traits. Once you put this link, there would be a various description about all the 5 factors, and at the end of this particular link there is a test which will show in which particular factor you are high or you are low. So today we are going to do that particular test right here in the video itself, so it would be easier for you to understand how you can do the scoring. It is a very simple test, nothing to be fear of. So before starting the test, I want you to be prepared with pencil and a paper in your hand, so it would be easier for you to note down the answer for yourself. Okay, so let's get started with the test. The test name is Mini IPIP Scale. Okay, it was designed in 2006. So I will read the instructions and then I will make you understand. Below are the phrases describing people's behaviors. Please use the rating scale below to describe how accurately each statement describes you. Describe yourself as you generally are now, not as you wish to or be in the future. Describe yourself as you honestly see yourself in relation to other people you know of the same sex as you are and roughly your same age. Please read each statement carefully and put a number from 1 to 5 next to it to describe how accurately the statement describes you. So there are 20 statements in this test. You have to read that particular statement, and then there is a rating of 1 to 5. So according to you, your own self, you need to write the rating next to that particular statement. Okay, and be loyal to whatever you are writing. Don't fake up the things. Okay, so this particular scores are will help you to know your own personality. So these are the 5 rating scales. Okay, 1 stands for very inaccurate, 2 stands for moderately inaccurate, 3 stands for neither inaccurate nor accurate, 4 stands for moderately accurate, and 5 stands for very accurate. So I will give you one of the examples. These are the 10 statements, right? So we will start with the first one. Now the first statement states that I am the life of the party, means without me the party seems to be boring. Okay, so now if this statement I apply on myself, I am the life of the party, so I think it is moderately accurate for me. Now what it is for you, you have to decide. So for me it is moderately accurate, so I would put over your number 4. So in your page you need to write 1, that is statement 1, and your answer, if it is 1 2 3 4 5, whatever it is, you need to write it next to it. So for me it would be statement 1, the answer for it is 4. Okay, now second is sympathizes with others' feeling. Okay, so for me it would be very accurate, so my answer would be 5. So again I will put statement 2, answer 5 for me. Now if it is very inaccurate for you, you will put 1 over there. So I want you all to write this particular rating scale in your margin first, and then we can start with the all the 20 statements. Okay, so I will give you 1 minute to write on the margin of your page. So you can write 1, VI, that is very inaccurate, 2, moderately accurate, MI, 3, you can write neither I nor A, 4th would be moderately accurate, MA, And fifth would be very accurate VA. So once you are done writing this on a margin, you will start with the 20 statements. Okay, so we will move with the 20 statements. So first one was, I am the life of the party. Second, sympathizes with others' feeling. Third, get course done right away. That means get work done right away. Fourth, have frequent mood swings. Fifth, have a vivid imagination. Sixth, don't talk a lot. So I hope you have written all the answers till six till now. Seventh, I'm not interested in other people problems. Eighth, often forget to put things back in their proper place. So you need to think, do you forget things putting in the proper place? Then you have to write the answer over there. You have to give the number over there. Ninth, I am relaxed most of the time. 10, I am not interested in abstract ideas. Now abstract ideas means that some ideas that are not physically present but are there in your mind. So I am not interested in abstract ideas. So it is related to O factor, creativity. I hope you are done with the 10 statements. If you are not done, you can go or reverse this video and you can write down the answers. We'll start with the 11th statement. Dash, talk to a lot of different people at the party. So do you talk to a lot of people at the party? Then you have to write the answer over there. 12, feel others' emotions. You understand other people's emotions. 13, like order. So you like to keep things in the order. That would is 13th. 14, get upset easily. You get sad easily. 15th, have difficulty understanding abstract ideas. So you are having difficulty to understand creative thinking. 16th, keep in the background. Means even if you are in the party, people are not that bothered. So you are kind of in the background during the party or whenever you are outside. So keep in the background. 17th, I am not really interested in others. 18th, make a mess of things. 19th, seldom feel blue. Now seldom feel blue means sometimes I feel sad. That is the meaning of seldom feel blue. 20th, do not have a good imagination. Okay, so whatever your answers are, I hope you have written it by the statement. So 1, 4, 2, 3, whatever it is, you have written according to the statement and you have given the number next to the statement. So I hope you have done all those 20 statements correctly. Now next we move on to the scoring part. So now we have given the answers to all the questions. Now we need to score, and it is very much important you understand how are you going to do the scoring, because it only depends upon the scoring what kind of personality trait you are having. Okay, so please pay attention on the scoring part. Now the scoring is divided into two parts. That is, first is reverse scoring and second is the normal scoring. So we will first understand what the reverse scoring is. I will read the instructions and then I will explain you. Scoring. द फर्स्ट थिंग यू मस्ट डू इज टू रिवर्स द आइटम्स दैट आर वर्डेड इन द ऑपोजिट डायरेक्शन. इन ऑर्डर टू डू दिस सब्ट्रैक्ट द नंबर यू पुट फॉर दैट आइटम फ्रॉम 6. सो इफ यू पुट फॉर इंस्टेंस अ 4, इट विल बिकम 2. क्रॉस आउट द स्कोर यू पुट व्हेन यू took the scale and put the new number representing your score subtracted from 6. Items to be reversed in this way is 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Okay, so what you have to do is for whatever statement number you have put up. So we'll start with the statement number 6. So for example, for the statement number 6, the answer you have put up is 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever the answer you have put up, you need to minus that particular answer by minus 6. Okay, so for example, if you have put up over there number 1, so you are going to minus it with 6, your answer will be 5. So the previous answer you need to cross it out and you need to write the new answer over there. Okay, similarly for statement 7, if you have given the earlier answer 2, for example, if you have given answer 2, you need to again minus it with the 6. So 6 minus 2, your new answer would be 4. Okay, so this way you need to do only for the statements given over here, that is 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 15, 16, 17, 18 and 19, 20. Only for these statements you are going to minus your original answer by minus 6 and then you will get a new answer that you need to write it down. Okay, so please do this for the entire 10 statements given over here. Okay, you need to minus whatever answer you have got, you need to minus it by 6. Please do that. Okay, so once you have done this, minusing the statements by minus 6, you got the new answer. Okay, keep it as it is. Now we will move to the next step. Next, you need to add up the score for each of the 5 scale, that is of ocean. Each ocean score will be sum of 4 items, place the sum next to the each scale below. Okay, so now what you have to do is, you got the new answers and you have the original answers of other statements which were not minus by 1. Okay, so now what you have to do, you have to, now this is the ocean, okay, this is the personality trait, the big 5 factor. So now you will get your original scores. So for openness to experience, to know what is your score for the openness to experience, you need to add the statement score of 5, 10, 15 and 20. Are you getting me? For the statement, like whatever the question number you have put, for example, for the statement 5, you put up the answer 2. Then for 10, you did a reverse scoring, that was minus by 6 and you got a new answer. So that you are going to add. Then again you are going to add whatever the answer was for 15th statement and whatever the answer was for the 20th statement. Okay, so for all 4 statements, you are going to add it and whatever score you are getting, that would be your score for openness to experience. So same way you need to do for other 4 factors, you need to add those score according to the factors given. So for openness to experience, you need to add the statements 5, 10, 15, 20. For conciseness, you need to add 3, 8, 13, 18. For extroversion, you need to add 1, 6, 11, 16. Then for agreeableness, you need to add 2, 7, 12, 17. For neuroticism, you need to add 4, 9, 14, 19. Okay, so all this you need to add it up for every other factor. Now it is very much important. You need to add whatever the score minus 6, after minusing 6, you got a new score. So that only you are going to add over here. Okay, not the earlier one. So with this, you get the score for all the five factors separately. Okay, so once this is done, your next step is, this is the particular scale. So you will understand where you lack, where you are in the which position you are when we talk about any particular factor. So for example, for openness to experience, you got the score of total score, you got 12. Okay, so we'll see in this particular scale. So 19 to 20 is extremely high, 17 to 18 is very high, and between 12 to 16 is high, 11 to 13 is neither high neither low, in the middle, 8 to 10 is low, 6 to 7 is very low, 4 to 5 is extremely low. So for the openness to experience, if I've got 12, so it comes between 11 to 13, so it is kind of medium. So my openness to experience is at the medium level. Okay, are you understanding? Same way for conciseness, if I have got, for example, I have got 18 for conciseness. Okay, so again I will check in this scale. So 18 comes in between 19 to 20, so it is extremely high. So my conciseness is extremely high. Then for extroversion, if I have got, suppose, score of 11, so we will see again where the 11 is. 11 again stands in the middle, so my score for extroversion is 11. Then agreeableness, if I have got the score of 7 in agreeableness, so that means my score is very low in agreeableness. Now we have read all the factors, so if the person is low in agreeableness, means the person is very argumentative. So according to score you will understand. So if you are high in extroversion, means you are extrovert person. If you are low at something, then accordingly the factors you need to check your personality. Again, the last one is neuroticism. So if I got 4 in neuroticism, means extremely low. So my negative emotions, my anger is very low, and that is what my neuroticism factor is stating over there. Okay, so once you get the score, you need to check on the scale whether are you at low or whether are you at high on the scale, and then you need to see what kind of personality it is showing. Okay, so I hope with this you have got what kind of personality you are having. So with this said, I hope you are clear with your doubts. If you have any doubts, feel free to write it in the comment box. I will try to answer it. So bye, take care, and thank you so much for watching this video. Bye.